Bernoulli's equation can be used for a number of different situations. In this particular video, we're going to apply it to what's known as a pitot-static tube. This is an example of a pitot-static tube, and the principle that it works on is you want to measure a pressure difference between two points where one of the points is considered a stagnation point. And a stagnation point is when the velocity equals zero. So if we start with Bernoulli's equation, it says that P1 pressure plus 1/2 times the density times V1 squared, which is the velocity, times the specific weight of the fluid times Z1 equals the same thing P2 plus 1/2 rho V2 squared plus gamma, the specific weight, times Z2. So we can make some assumptions that make this a lot easier. So if we say that Z1 equals Z2, in other words, it's horizontal, we also will say that 2 is going to be the stagnation point, so V2 equals 0. What we're now left with is that P1 plus 1/2 rho V1 squared equals P2. So we can use this equation either to solve for a difference in pressure, or we can use this equation to solve for an actual pressure given the other pressure. So let's say we have a plane, and we have at the nose of the plane a pitot-static tube, and we have far away a point. And what we want to do is find the pressure difference between points 1 and point 2. So what do we know about this airplane? Well, we're given that it's flying at 100 meters per second. Its elevation is 4,000 meters. And we will use the expression we developed before. P2 equals P1 plus 1/2 rho V1 squared. So the simplest way to do this is that P2 minus P1 equals 1/2 rho V1 squared. And we know that our V is 100 meters per second. We can look up the density of air at a temperature of about minus 11 degrees C. So this is 0.8194 kilograms per meter cubed. So our delta P is 1/2 times 0.8194 times 100 meters per second squared, or our delta P is about 4.1 kilopascals. We can also look up P1. So if we look up the pressure of air at 4,000 meters, we find that that equals 6.2 times 10 to the fourth pascals, or 62 kilopascals.